write down analytical solution. This is first of all second order differential equation, isn't it? Have you seen second order differential equation before? Where? SHM, simple harmonic motion, is what? Acceleration is equal to minus omega square x. So A is what? D square x by dt square plus omega square x equals to 0, right? Instead of x, q is there. Fine. This is the second order differential equation. You know that solution of this differential equation is what? X equal to A sine omega t plus theta. Fine. So any second order differential equation will have a generic solution as a sine or cosine function. This is the assumption actually. Okay. So we will assume that the solution of this equation, this differential equation, is given as q is equal to qm sine of omega t plus phi. This omega and this omega, they are same. Okay? Because this frequency is the property of a system. So the system is oscillating with this frequency omega, so omega will not change, frequency doesn't change just like that. So q is equal to qm sine omega t plus phi is the solution of this, but we don't know what is qm and we don't know what is phi. How will you find out then what is the value of qm and phi? How will you find out? Is there a way to find out? If this is a solution of this differential equation, then you can substitute this value here. Yes or no? If this solution of that, it should satisfy this equation. Right? So put it here and try to rearrange the term and get it properly. You arrange sine of term, you get sine and cos both. You take sine separately and cos separately.
Cos omega
t. Done?
Cos omega t. No.
Q omega cos omega t. Then we will check again.
Q omega square
sine. Say dq by dt will be qm omega cos omega t plus phi. Fine, so these values just substitute here. Okay, you will get minus of qm. So your equation will become very dirty. I mean, it becomes, you know, horrible. But then deal with it. I mean, there is no as such, what I say, you just have to be careful so that you don't make any silly error. There is no conceptual irregularities you will be making here. Just silly error you will be making because this equation becomes very big. So this is into sine of omega t plus phi plus r times qm omega cos of omega t plus phi plus q by c. So 1 by c times q omega here. Qm sine omega t plus phi. This is equal to qm sine omega t plus, this is equal to, sorry, vm sine omega t. Okay, now let's take sine omega t common. If you take sine omega t common, you will get qm omega, I'll take qm omega sine omega t plus phi common. Okay? I will get 1 by omega c minus omega l. You know why I have taken q m omega common? Because this is familiar to me. Plus, you can take q omega common throughout. You will get plus r times cos of omega t plus phi is equal to vm sin omega t. Okay? So, this is what xc. So, xc minus xl into sin of omega t plus phi plus r times cos of omega t plus phi is equal to vm divided by qm omega sin omega t. Any doubt? Okay. You know what is Z? Impedance is what?
Z is xc minus xl
whole square plus r square under root. Fine. So now what you do?
Square.
You divide throughout by Z. Divide and multiply by Z. Okay. So if you do that, there is a reason why we do that. See, this is a common trick. If you get C1 sin theta plus C2 cos theta, what you do? You multiply and divide by root over C1 square plus C2 square. This will let you write it as a single trigonometric function. This is C1 square plus C2 square. So this will be equal to C1 square plus C2 square sine of theta plus phi, where tan of phi is equal to C2 by C1. This you assume as cos phi, this automatically becomes sin phi. It's a common trick. Getting it? So this will let you write in a simpler manner. Similarly here, Z is what? Root over this square plus that square. Okay? So I can write down this as Z into is it very overwhelming? Are you able to handle it? Any doubt, you let me know. Let's slow down. This is like...
Can you just repeat the XL part? What
repeat the man?
Okay.
He's like, okay, can you repeat something? And then, okay, yeah, it is fine. Tell me if you have any doubts.
Why are we doing the impedance?
Impedance is just incidental. It happens to be impedance. The trick is this only. Root over C1 square plus C2 square happens to be impedance. Getting it? And it is good that it is impedance because it is familiar to us. Okay? So I can say that this entire thing as cos of theta, this is sine of omega t plus phi. If this is cos theta, that will become sine theta. Plus sine theta cos of omega t plus phi is equal to something. Okay. So this, what I can write? I can write that as z times sine of omega t plus theta plus phi. Okay. This equals to Vm times Vm divided by Qm omega sin omega t. Okay? So basically impedance should be equal to Vm divided by Qm times omega. So Qm should become Vm divided by omega z. We got the value of Qm. You're comparing these two.
Okay.
Okay. And what is theta? Theta is such that tan theta is equal to, you assume that to be sine theta,
sure.
This to be cos theta. So tan theta will be equal to r divided by xc minus xl. okay?
C minus F.
It does, yeah, x c minus f. Okay, so theta plus phi should become what? Theta plus phi should become 0 or 2 pi or 4 pi, whatever. So best thing is it takes 0. So theta will be equal to minus so our solution was like phi we need, right? Phi is equal to minus of theta. So phi will be equal to minus of tan inverse r divided by xc minus xl. In the textbook, what they have done, they have assumed q is equal to qm cos of omega t plus phi. So, when you read from the textbook, you just consider the fact that you have taken sine, not the cos. So, if you take as cos, everything will rearrange and you will get tan of theta to be xc minus xl by r. Fine? So, here rather than sine, you will get cos. Here you get sine. So this you assume at sin theta, this you assume at cos theta. Okay. Fine. So this is analytical solution. Any doubt till now? Anything? We'll do some numerical on whatever you learned till now. This is considered to be the difficult derivation from this. To do it one or twice. One is one, the same thing can be derived using phasor or using analytical method. You got the value of charge q, you can differentiate it, you will get the value of current. Okay, using phasor we got the value of current. Okay, do this question. A resistor kya xl, what is the unit of impedance?
Ohm.
Find out current VRMS across resistance and VRMS across capacitance. Three things you have to find out: current, voltage across resistance, voltage across capacitance. See, for impedance, it doesn't matter whether inductor is there or not. If inductor is not there, it will have only XC. XL will be 0. Did you get the answer? Anything? Get the value of impedance first. How much it is? In this case, impedance will be root over R square plus XC square. XC is 2 and 2?
Yeah.
This is under root 200 square.
So 4021, root over 4021.
How much is that roughly? That's approximately 291.5 ohm. So I'm telling you the value. Z is 212.291.5. Now get the value of a current VRMS across R and across C. That is RMS voltage.
Yeah, so V will be RMS.
So I is...
No.
I is equal to V minus...
Total V is that. It's not V across R.
I is equal to V by Z.
For current you need to find R.
For current.
So is I equal to 1.04?
No. How can it be? You're getting impedance less... 291 is less than 220.
220 into 1.4.
You got the maximum current.
Yeah, because it's
only... No. When I say just find out the current, I mean RMS current.
Oh.
and this is V by Z.
I don't know.
How much?
Then what if you get IRMS value, right?
Yeah, I want IRMS only.
Oh.
IRMS is 220 divided by 291.5. This is 0.7 or something.
Yes, 0.7.
Okay. Now get the value of voltage across resistance and across capacitance. Okay, did you get VR and VC?
We can get from that.
You called me, right?
Yeah.
VR and VC. How much is that? VR is simply I into R. VC is what?
I into XC.
I into XC. Good.
Is
how
it
much is
VR? 151.
151 volt. VC is? XC again, huh? XC is 212. And current is this? What is VC?
Yeah.
Okay? But isn't it weird that sum of these two is more than 220? Ideally,
yeah.
There is this and a resistance connected to a voltage source. Sum of this voltage plus that voltage should give you this. Right? Source is 220, voltage across resistance is 151, voltage across capacitance is 160. Sum of these two voltages is like 311, which is more than 220. How come? And nothing is wrong. So what is, how will you, you know, visualize what is happening? Sum of this plus this should be equal to that or not? Yes or no?
Yeah.
No.
No.
Why? Why no?
Because that's VR.
No, that's not the reason.
Is it because of the induced EMF?
No. You can't add them like that. They are vectors. They are phasors. They are 90 degree away, right? VC is 90 degree away from VR or not?
Yeah.
So basically, what should happen, root over 151 square plus 160 square should give you 220, and which is correct. Fine. Because VR is this and VC is this. Sum of these two voltages will be taken as a Pythagoras theorem because they are 90 degrees. Any doubt till now? So we are halfway this chapter. We'll finish it off next class and we'll solve few questions. But you guys have to come better prepared. I'm still feeling that you're not putting the hard work which is required. You think that you might be working hard or you don't have time and all, but then that's not true. There are many students who are working really, really hard and they are lakhs in number, not hundreds. You're competing with them. Pull your socks. It's very important. And the worst is, you will not get second chance to correct your mistake. The mistake you do right now stays with you throughout your life. The repercussions. You'll not get like, oh, I made a mistake, let me correct it. That will not happen. So what I'm telling you, take it seriously. Don't make an error. Okay? So solve as many questions as possible. And you start revising class 11th also. Every week, take one chapter of physics, chemistry and math and try to revise that. Do questions from Maxi Verma or any book, whatever you have.